Hello, this is a very special day. It is called the National Day of Prayer. And we want to spend just a few moments with you to talk about prayer and how important it is that we pray and then pray.
I want to share with you two scriptures from the Bible today. 2 Chronicles 7, verse 14. This is in the Amplified Bible. It's the last part of that verse. It says, "If my people will humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, I will hear from heaven and forgive their sin and heal their land." So God says, if my people, and we are God's people. If you're a born-again believer, you are God's people. And it says that we need to humble ourselves, we need to pray, and we need to seek his face and turn from our wicked ways. And if we do that, then God said he will hear us, he will forgive our sins, and heal our land. And you know, even though this is the National Day of Prayer, and we all need to pray today, but we need to have a continual prayer life. We need to be praying every day for our country, mm-hmm. and our nation, and our government, and our family. And then another verse is James 5, verse 16, and this is in the Amplified. It says, "The heartfelt, persistent prayer of a righteous man is able to accomplish much when put into action and made effective by God. It is dynamic and can have tremendous power." It says the heartfelt. In other words, you're praying from your heart. It's not all from your head. And it says a persistent prayer. I mean, you're praying persistently. You're continually. And it says the prayer of a righteous man. That's the believer. It's not saying that you have to be perfect, but it's the born-again believer, have right standing with God. That we're able to, through prayer, we're able to accomplish much. And it says that it is dynamic. Our prayer unto God is dynamic, mm-hmm. and has tremendous power. And, you know, all through the Bible, you can read where people prayed unto God, and God brought victories and deliverance, and he helped people, and he changed situations, and we serve the same God. He's the same yesterday, today, and forever. And so it's so important that we pray during this time, because God still answers prayer.
You know, the Bible says in 1 Timothy chapter 2 and verse 1, it says, "I exhort therefore that first of all supplications, prayers, intercessions, and giving of thanks be made for all men, for kings, and for all that are in authority, that we may lead a quiet and peaceable life in all godliness and honesty. For this is good and acceptable in the sight of God, our Savior." So we'll be praying. I'm going to lead you to a prayer. Matter of fact, as I pray, I want you to agree with me. We're going to bring up petitions. Matter of fact, you can teach by example, and you can teach in the Word. But I want you to kind of pray a prayer, an example for you to pray. And so let's just pray and on this special day. Heavenly Father, we come to honor you this special day, the National Day of Prayer. We come to you as a nation to acknowledge that you are the only one who can rightly lead and guide this country. We ask that you will bless our country with your wisdom, your love, and your compassion. May we be a people who are pursuing you and your plans for us individually and corporately. Lord, we pray for our leaders. May those who are in their position of authority take that responsibility seriously and do it their best every day, but not to abuse the people, but to bless the people. May they realize their need for you and for your direction. For we cannot make it, Father, without you. May they hear your voice as they make their decisions. And may they follow your guidelines and your guidance. May they have a passion for people, for truth, and for righteousness. Lord, we lift up all of those who are in leadership position in our government, locally and nationally. And may they be endowed with wisdom, strength, and justice to administer their duties in a manner that is right and pleasing, Father, in your sight. Lord, we pray for our troops, for blessings, our service men and women. We ask protection for all our men and women in uniform, both here and around the world. We are grateful for their service and their dedication to keeping our nation safe. We pray that you will keep them safe, Father. We pray for this nation. We pray for the world that you will be glorified during this time and during this season. No matter, there is no weapon formed against the church shall prosper. We thank you for our blessing of blessings of life and liberty. We pray that our country will show love and honor to you. May our dedication to you cause us to reach out to all the other nations with a strong desire for peace and harmony to be displayed whenever possible. Heavenly Father, we thank you that you have heard our prayer. We thank you, Heavenly Father, for who you are and that you do love us and that your heart is with this nation. We thank you, give you all the praise, all the glory for what you will do, what you have done. In Jesus' name, amen. You know, and furthermore, the other day, a couple of days ago, you know, the Lord uses me a lot on the area of psalms, giving psalms and words of inspiration. Her and I was at the house a couple of days ago, and in the morning she was just talking. You know how you talk before you go to the office. You were just talking. She said, you know what? America is my home. This is my home. This is where I live. And the devil cannot have it. He cannot have my home. He cannot have our home. Talking about the world, the area, that the America that we live in. And it just stirred me up. I said, you're right, honey. We got to the office, and I sat down at the office. You know, sometimes people can say certain things that will trigger a word that I'll give it out. Well, when I got to the office, sat down, this came to me. I said, yeah, that is so true. And words of inspiration came to me. Now, this is a different kind of prayer. This is called Our Prayer for America. The Lord gave this to me a couple of days ago, words of inspiration. You know, we prayed a prayer of our petition to God. But this is a different kind of prayer that you need to pray this. Now, if you'd like to have a copy of this, just email me at pastormoss@bellsouth.net. PastorMoss@BellSouth.net, and I'll send this to you, and you can pray this. You can pray this every day. So before I pray this and read this, I'm going to read this scripture. Ezekiel 22, verse 30. And I sought for a man among them that should make up the hedge and stand in the gap before me for the land, that I should not destroy it, but I found none. What we need to do as a nation, we need to quit griping and complaining and groaning and moaning of what they're doing, because it's spirits behind them. It's not, you cannot just get so upset with people. Don't have a hatred in your heart toward the leaders of the land. Just walk in the love of God and pray, as the Bible says, first of all, pray for them. And now, since we pray, now we're going to talk to the devil. You have that God-given authority in this nation to rise up, and many are rising up in this day and hour, and they're taking their authority. I know we have, because we have the God-given authority to tell the devil to get his hands off of our stuff. So this came to me, and let me pray this through reading it, and it goes this way. America is our home, and Satan, we have had enough. In the name of Jesus, take your hands off of this nation and our stuff. It is the land of the free, and this will always be our home. So bow your knees in the name of Jesus. Leave and be gone. You are trying to use some leaders in order to bring us down. It won't work, because in the name of Jesus, we are standing on solid ground. We bind you in the name of Jesus from sending leaders to attack. We demand our rights, because this is our land and we're taking it back. Take your hands off of the small businesses, for they are essential. Employers and employees are needed, because the jobs has great potential. In the name of Jesus, take your hands off of our churches in this land. You will not and cannot stop us because of the blood on which we stand. Satan, you are a liar, and everything you say is not true but false. And we will continue to fight for this nation through prayer at all cost. We bind every spirit that is spreading discord throughout our nation. We have had enough, and we will not put up with any evil invasion. In the name of Jesus, take your hands off of our leaders and our president. This is our land, and we call it America, which is our home and residence. Satan, we serve you. Notice that you have already been bound with authority, and we will enjoy our lives together in the land that we love, which is America, the land of the free. I believe that is inspired of the Holy Ghost, that we, the people of the America, of the land of the free, need to rise up and say, devil, we have had enough. And the best way to continue to fight the good fight of faith, spend time in prayer, people. Pray for the nation. Pray for the leaders. Don't criticize. Don't have that critical. There's so much hatred going around. But this is a national day of prayer that we need to bind together. They that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. We need to bind together and be men and women of the gospel and be soldiers of the Lord Jesus Christ, and don't go our way. Let's continue to pray, and I guarantee you, you'll see a change in this nation. Oh, God is doing a work in this nation. We have not seen nothing yet. So praise God for America. Anything else, honey, you want to say? Blessed be the name of the Lord.
I know a lot of people's out protesting, going out, you know, in front of the courthouses and protesting. But I tell you what, we can do a lot more if we get on our knees and pray.
Amen.
Because God answers prayer. When we get on our knees, and if you're, you know, like he said, if you'd like to have a copy of that, email him. Get a copy of that. That's just not for today. That's for every day.
This is it.
We can take that and pray that every day over our nation. And we need to expect that things are going to change. It's not going to stay this way because God's working on our behalf. We need to expect every
Amen.
Day to get better. The future's bright. You know, this is just temporary. And everything that we're going through is going to change. And it's going to change for the better. And so, you know, let's continue to pray, not just today only, but let's continue to pray every day before God. And God comes, he answers, he brings help, he brings deliverance, he brings healing. The Bible said he will heal our land, and that's
Amen.
What we need right now. So we thank God that we're able to pray and come before his presence. The Bible says, come boldly to the throne of grace
Amen.
And make our petitions known unto him. And it says, you know, for in time of help, and that he'll show us mercy and grace. And so this day, that's what we're doing all throughout the United States. On this day of prayer, we're going before him with our petitions, and he will answer our prayers.
Well, before we conclude, we're going to stretch forth our hand to you that's watching this, whether in YouTube or Facebook or home or whatever, and we're going to pray for you. Father, in the name of Jesus, we come before you. We pray for all those that has watched this broadcast. We pray in the name of the Mangro Desi, Dingla Mangro Dose, Glade Briggs, the Mangro Deste, Linga Mangro Dose. We speak peace over that family. We speak peace over that husband. We speak peace over the wife and the kids. In the name of Jesus, we thank you, Father God, for blessing the people. We thank you for blessing the America. We pray for the United States of America. We bless you. We worship you. We thank you, Lord. And we speak peace in the name of Jesus. And we thank you for it right now. The peace of God, which passeth all understanding, now abide in them. So they will not be afraid. For you have told us in your word, fear thou not, for I am with you. Be not dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you.
Yes.
Yea, I will help you. Yea, I will hold you with the right hand of my righteousness. And you said that you have not given us a spirit of fear, but a power and of love and of a sound mind. So as we go off, I want to remind you, be bold in prayer and let the devil know you've had enough and you're going to keep on praying. Amen. Praise God. God bless you, and we love you. Have a great day.